Hey guys, it's All Things Fun in Florida again. I'm going to go ahead and do my recap a little early. This week was not very good for estate sales, but I did have some pretty good thrifting luck this week. So first I'm going to go ahead and go through some of the sales. So had quite a few sales this week. I think I did about $280 in sales, maybe a little more. Sold the J.R. Tolkien Hobbit Lord of the Rings box set. That was pretty good. I picked that up for a couple bucks. Sold it for $23. Sold a few of my mystery packs. Sold an FBI Citizens Academy duffel bag. That was a pretty good pickup. I picked it up for $3, and it sold for $42.99 plus shipping. So that was a pretty decent one. The Microsoft Xbox I picked up a couple weeks ago that had the red ring of death. Sold that for parts. Wound up getting about $14.50, $14.50 I think for that. Sold a Dogma video. This is why you got to pay attention when you're listing. I bought it for $218 and I wound up selling it for $319. After fees, listing, packaging, I probably lost about $1 on that. So I'm not sure why it was $3.99. I think it was probably supposed to be $6.99, but went up $3.99 and somebody jumped on it. So there's not much I can do about that. Sold a Wii game, Major League Power Pros, Xbox One game, Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon, Wildlands. Some of the miscellaneous vintage fishing lures and fishing equipment that I had in a lot finally sold. Got about $8.50 for that. I think I spent maybe, it was an estate sale. I had about 25-30 items and I paid $16 for all of them, so I really don't even know what I had into it, but it was basically a dollar or less. Then I sold a couple baseballs, new in the box 1990s vintage American League and a National League baseball going out to the same person. I sold the other Wii remote Joy-Con for the black Wii for $15.99 plus shipping. And then the Sentinel One military action figures I picked up, I sold. Didn't make a lot of money off of those, but I made about $4 or $5 off those. That's not really that great of a sale. But last week when I bought the RC airplane and boating parts, that auction closed. I bought that entire box for $20. I had a bunch of little receivers and different wires and things that were new in the package. So I bundled those up and I still had the all the motors, the canvas, and all the other tools and stuff that was in there. But the just the RC parts sold for $46. Not a bad flip right there. I had bought a couple little jewelry trinket boxes at an estate sale about a month ago. They've been listed for a long time. I paid $4 and two of them sold for $8.99. So I'm in the profit pretty good there. And I sold a PSP NFL Street 2 Unleashed Sony game. And then Sid Meier's Civilization, I sold a expansion pack for PC for that. So, not too bad. Had quite a few sales, was busy with packing and delivering. Let's go ahead and get into what I picked up this week. Let's see, where to start? I guess we'll start with toys. Bought a lot of Imaginex vehicles. Couple little bat aircraft, the helicopter, the penguin, little submarine. Say that one for last. And the bat boat. Those are all Imaginex. And then this little 6.5-inch action figure. Haven't even looked him up yet, see what he is. But bought all of that. It was $4.98 for all of those. So not a bad purchase. Not a bad pickup. Let's see. Also picked up this bag of Lincoln Logs. I don't know if you guys know anything about Lincoln Logs, but they're just these large logs right here will pay for the whole bag. There's four of them in there. Those will sell for $7 or $8 for the four of them. So this lot of Lincoln logs will probably sell for around $20-$25. So I picked them up for $4. Let's see. Stick with toys, I guess. One of the only estate sale finds I had was this Lost in Space classic. It's a vintage Johnny Lightning. It's the Rover, the Chariot, I think they called it. So this is a 1998. So is that? I think that's considered vintage, but not bad. New in a package. I also picked up out of state sailing. Picked up two iPod. I think these are Nanos. Not bad. Working condition for the black one. It works fine. The green one, the battery shot. As long as you have it plugged in, it works fine. So this one will be sold at a little discount. This is one of the newer models. It's got the video camera. So this is actually the nicer of the two. So not sure what these will bring, but we'll see. Let's see. Oh. You know how I am about media. This is the other purchase I made at the estate sale. New in the pack, video cassette, VCR tapes, you know, VHS. So, I bought that car and these and some puzzle books that I was going to send to my grandma because they were large print. But when I got them home, they're probably not the right kind. So I might still send them to her, but I think I paid $3 for all of that. So. All right, thrift store. Not sure, I think this is a pretty decent racket. It's a Prince Diablo. It's carbon fiber. It's titanium tungsten carbide, I think. See if you can see. I don't think the light's good enough that you can see that. But you can see the price tag. I paid $298 for this racket. So, got a guy at work. I'm going to ask him if I've got a good deal, and we'll see what he says. Also, it picked up this Yonex RQ120 wide body racket. Pretty good shape. The cover was dirty, so I cleaned it up, and it cleaned up really well. So, but this is a pretty good racket as well. Probably sell for around $30. I picked it up for $298. So that seems to be Goodwill's price for rackets. They don't seem to know much about tennis. So you can pick up about any racket for $298 from Goodwill. Let's see. Oh, this is a nice find. This is a Tesla messenger's bag. Looks to be almost brand new. The only defect I can find on it is the sticky mark from the price tag that Goodwill put on it. But picked that up for $398, and they're selling for a wide range, anywhere from $89 down to $59, and currently there are none listed on eBay. So this should do pretty good. I'm probably going to put it on there high and see what happens. So that's a great pickup. Some littler things. Shimano cleat set. Got a price tag on it for $20.99. Goodwill had $1.18 on it. New in the package. Can't go wrong there. So pick those up. Grab this HP 10 Bravo 2 calculator. You know, just a standard scientific calculator. I figured it'd be, you know, another $8-$10 buy. I paid $1.18 for it. So, this is probably one of the better things I picked up. This is a reel-to-reel tape, new in the package. So I picked it up. It didn't have a price tag at all. When I got up to the front, I asked her what it was. The lady didn't feel like messing with it, so she said, I'll put $1 on it. So I paid $1 for this. Then when I looked them up, The new ones are selling. The new ones that haven't been used are selling for $45 to $65. So that's going to be a really good flip right there. A couple books. These aren't really for sale. I'm giving these to the kids. Chronicles of Narnia. Something I read as a kid. So I'm going to give those to the kids and let them read them for their school. They got to read 20 minutes a night for school. So, I Kill Giants from the producers of Harry Potter. Never heard of it, but it's still sealed. Paid $2 for that. Took a chance with that. We'll see what that goes for. And then the first complete season of Saturday Night Live. I paid $4 for that. We'll see how that does. Golf balls. Don't know anything about golf balls. I got a complete box of Maxi Fly Noodle, long and soft. The price tag on it says 0.01. I might have overpaid if that's the true price, but I paid $5 for all these golf balls. So brand new in the box. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I could get the $5 back. Picked up this Nerf gun. Don't usually buy Nerf guns, but whenever I see the vintage Nerf guns that are in pretty good shape, like this one, this is one of the 1993. So this one's in pretty good shape. Just doesn't have the darts is the only thing that's missing. So I was looking these up. They're selling around $20, $25 in this condition. So not a bad purchase. It was $1.18 as well. Garage sale, a bunch of poles. Paid $1 for them. Might be good, might not be. Not everything can be a winner. So, you know how I am about media. So, whenever I see, you know, new in the package media, I usually pick it up. So, paid $2 for that. Epson's ink. Paid $2 a piece for these. They're already past the sell-by date, but they were selling for about $20, $25 a box, even expired. So we'll go ahead and take a chance on those. Let's see. Oh, Ed Hardy sunglass case. Paid $2 for that. I just thought it looked cool. Figured I'd take a chance with $2. Ed Hardy stuff is usually pretty popular, so. Electronics here. I got two mini digital recorders. Picked these up at two different places, but each one of them were $1. So I just had to purchase them, and then $1 came, another $1 got me the three sealed tapes. So not a bad deal. Both of them work. The battery boxes are clean, so I think it'll be a good buy. Picked up this little Cool Baby HD video game, little Nintendo. It's got 600 of the old Nintendo games already built in. Believe it or not, this thing is selling used for about $35. And this was a buy earlier in the week. I think I paid $6 for this. So that's a little more than I probably would have paid, but I figured if I couldn't sell it, the kids would play with it, so. Alright, this is a kind of a weird little buy I made. Price tag was a little high. I paid $7 for these. Oops. And they're falling out. We'll just dump them into this box. These are little radio switches. These are used on boats, semi trucks. They have their little console, the Volvo pinhole consoles they have. And these just plug into the console. So, I don't know, I got about, there's probably 50 of them in there. I figured if I could sell them, lot them up and sell 5 or 10 of them at a time for $6 or $7 is probably a pretty good pretty good little profit going to come out of my $7 there, but we'll see how long that takes to sell. Let's see. Some games. Ready to Rumble 2. Told myself I wasn't going to buy any more older PlayStation games or Xbox 360, but I ran into this one, and I'd had this roached out version right here, but it was missing one of the discs, so now I have a complete set with the limited edition box, so we'll see how that does. I'll probably keep Ready to Rumble 2 boxing, because I really enjoyed that game back when I was younger. Me and Henry will play that for a while. Got a couple little things. $1.18, little flashlight still in the package. Vintage. What are they? Bebe sunglasses. I've looked these up. You know, Bebe sunglasses are still selling, so I figured I'd take a chance for a dollar. If not, I'll throw them in a drawer until the next generation thinks they're cool. Little Funko Pop. Found that one. Looked it up. Seems to be selling for about $14-15. I paid $2 for it, so can't go wrong. Box is still in pristine condition, so. This was actually a really good buy right here. This is a snorkel and fins. So it's an aqua lung mask. Still has the sticker on the mask. There is some sand on it, but it does not appear to ever really been used. So the aqua lung mask, they sell for about $35 to $40. Then usually I figure you get these and you open them up and it's usually Walmart, you know, fins, the little cheap plastic ones. So there's the aqua lung snorkel, but came with the Twin Jet Scuba Pro. These, you may not be able to see it very well, but these are incredibly heavy and solid fins. So these sell for $70, $80 used. New, they're over $100. So, and it even came with the accessory pack with the upgrade to the backs. And this is what really sealed the deal for me, because it didn't have a price tag, so I didn't really want to mess with it. But it came with these aftermarket stainless steel spring clips for the backs. And these replaced the adjustable ones. And these sell for about $35 new, just alone. So, and had some dive gloves and some other little pocket snorkel thing. So I went ahead and I carried it up to the front. Ooh, good catch. The desk caught it for me. I carried it up to the front, asked them what the price was, and I'm thinking they were going to say $29, $35, somewhere around there. And they put a price tag on it of $14.99. So for $14.99, I probably have about $100 worth of used snorkel gear. So it's a little heavier than I like to ship and a little bigger. But for, you know, 7-8 times the profit there, I'll go ahead and go through the hassle of sending this out with FedEx. But not a bad buy. I think that was a good buy, man. Got a few hats. Orange Tag Day is half off, so they were marked $2.98. Got them for $1.49 a piece. This is one I like the most. It's a vintage Vans off the wall. It's got the old velour lining in there, so I'm gonna have to look this one up and see exactly how vintage it is, or if it's a reproduction to make it look like it's vintage. It could have been either one. But then I got an Avalanche hat, Virginia Tech, and Kansas City Royals youth hat there, so not too bad. Got six hats for less than $10. I think I'll get my money back there. New in the box, Spinergy. Paid $3 for that. Campaign, Tactical and Strategic War Simulations, Empire. This is a vintage computer game, still in the plastic. And I think it probably has floppy disks with it. The date for this is 1992. So I'm pretty sure that's the floppy disk era. Maybe even the 5 1/4s. But not too bad. Pick this up, Risk Legacy. It appears to be complete, but I'm not 100% sure because it was opened. So, not a bad... what did I pay for that? Price tags off it. I think this was $3 as well. So, most of the games are around $3. And then I picked up another baseball bat. This Easton composite. It's the S1 IMX Advanced Composite model. So, 29 inches. I don't know if I want to get into selling baseball bats, but when you see a baseball bat that sells for $140, $150 bucks and it's only $2.98, I just feel like I need to pick that up. So, and if anything, I'll just let the little one beat baseballs around in the backyard with it. So, that looks like about everything. Had a really good week in sales. Had a great early in the week picking up all those... Nintendo GameCube games. Still haven't got those listed, haven't tested them. I was able to test the PSPs and sold that. Sold one of those already, put up a lot. The lot's doing really well. So I think those are gonna make a good profit there as well. I still got a bunch of the electronics from that remote control buy to get listed as well. All the motors and some of the bigger new parts and used parts. So those will be going up on the eBay store as well. Looks like I got quite a bit of stuff. Running out of storage space, so my wife's getting mad. So if you're watching this, go to my eBay store and start buying some stuff so I can get rid of it. All right, thanks for coming along, guys. I'll see you next week.